Crohn's and colitis, unless you are stricken with them yourself or you know someone who has been stricken with these illnesses, are usually something we're not really familiar with unless we see them in a pharmaceutical commercial or something like that. So to raise the level of awareness and find out how many people these afflictions do strike, especially here in the Santa Clarita Valley, I have some wonderful guests with me here today to talk about an event that's going to raise awareness. It's called the event is called Santa Clarita Take Steps for Crohn's and Colitis, location at Bridgeport Park this Saturday, October 12th. From 5 o'clock, and the walk starts at 6. The event coordinator, Sam, good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
And we also have with us, we have Emily Horak. Pronounced your name right? Did I get it?
Yes, you got
it. All right.
That.
See, I am a professional. But we want to talk a little bit first. Sam, just tell me a little bit about the event and what's going to entail.
Ooh, the event's going to be a lot of fun. It's on, as you said, Saturday, October 12th from 5 to 7. From 5 to 6, we will be having a festival of sorts with lots of really great fall-themed kids activities. We're doing pumpkins and all sorts of other types of kids activities that are fall themed. I just said that.
It's all good. It's all good.
And then the walk starts at 6 p.m. and it's a beautiful stroll through Bridgeport Park. It's about a 2 mile walk for all levels of fitness and an ability. So it's going to be a lot of fun.
That's a nice place to walk to because it's relatively flat surfaces and a nice way to get outdoors and help support this cause. Now, as far as fundraising, what can people do to help?
Well, we always use donations. We're trying to raise $24,000 for this event. And we've so far raised, I think, over $10,000, which is really exciting. And people can go to our website and donate. It's www.cctakesteps.org/Santa Clarita. You can also come out to the walk and be a part of the action. We have a $25 suggested minimum donation, but it gets you all the entertainment for the afternoon, delicious food from Z Pizza, Chick-fil-A, Nothing But Cakes, and Whisk Gluten-Free Bakery, who are all donating really awesome food. Oh, and Cutie's Juice. So we have a lot of great stuff.
Great opportunity to get out and also learn more about what this is about. Tell me a little bit about where these funds will go to.
CCFA's mission is to cure Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis and to improve the lives of those who are affected by it. So our funds go directly toward support programming and research right here in the Santa Clarita Valley. We do education programs. We do support groups. We have camp for kids that have Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, which I think Miss Emily can attest to here how much fun it is. And also, you know, our primary mission is cures, finding cures for these diseases. 82 cents of every dollar CCFA spends goes into finding cures and finding support programs for these for people with IBD.
Well, Emily, let's talk about your story a little bit. You are afflicted with which one?
I have Crohn's disease.
Crohn's disease. Tell me a little bit about what that is.
Crohn's disease is basically inflammation in your intestinal tract. So I have inflammation in my small intestine and my colon.
And it obviously, aside from discomfort, it actually is debilitating in a way, correct?
Exactly. A lot of nausea and stomach pain, and it's hard sometimes when you're doing things where you want to be active and get out, and you have stomach pain to be able to power through that. So it definitely affects your life.
Right. Now, I was looking at your story, which is here online at online.ccfa.org, and that's underneath where the information about the event is. And telling your story, at first you were saying you were very shy about it and didn't want to let people know, but you decided to change that up and start sharing your story.
Yeah, definitely when you're in high school, the thing is to blend in and not really be noticed. And after being diagnosed with Crohn's, I lost a lot of weight, and I just didn't feel necessarily comfortable or like I could be myself when I had to fight this battle that people didn't necessarily know I was fighting. So I think I've learned by sharing my story and telling other people. A lot of people have relatives who have it, and it's a discussion that isn't really brought up, and I think that's something great to be able to bring it up and raise awareness and make people realize that this is real and people really have it.
Now, this is something, too, that a lot of people who have stomach problems sometimes, and maybe they think it's just something they're eating or they're going through a change. Perhaps sometimes adolescence, you have all those kind of things going on, but also at many different stages of life. Are there things that people maybe should look out for to maybe, or symptoms that maybe they might want to consider getting a second opinion or looking a little deeper?
I definitely didn't have a normal case when I first got diagnosed, and I was nauseous almost every single day, every second for months. So I would definitely say if nausea or a lot of stomach pain persists, definitely go see that out. And any blood and anything, that definitely needs to be checked out. That's one of the classic symptoms. So.
And have you, in actually getting out there and discussing your situation, have you actually been able to bring to light some information that's had other people go, thank you for talking about it because I think I have this? Or have you been able to at least share your story?
I think the biggest thing is actually finding people who have it and who don't want to say anything and making them feel that it's okay to be different. I think that's been the biggest thing I found from sharing my story.
Yeah, a lot of people don't realize because it's a tough conversation to have. Hey, I can't go out. I'm just not feeling it. Oh, what's wrong? Well, you know, I can understand that kind of hesitance there, but also to have that support group and really building together and being able to support one another, I think is really, really important on something like this. And it kind of helps you get through it. You know, other people are kind of going through the same thing.
Exactly. That's what makes the CCFA so amazing, especially some of their camp programs and support groups, of finding other people who have the disease.
And you will be there this weekend, obviously, as well.
I will definitely be there.
All right. This has been terrific and very uplifting and motivating. Emily Horak, we continue to wish you the best of luck in your continued treatments and success. And Sam, the coordinator for the event, this is, we're talking about the Santa Clarita Takes Steps for Crohn's and Colitis. This is an awareness and a fundraising event. Bridgeport Park. It is a walk through the lovely area. The Bridgeport Park community is a lovely walk and a lovely place smack in the middle of awesome town. So you want to check it out. October 12th, the check-in and festival begins at 5 o'clock. The walk will begin at 6. And you can learn more at, give me the website again.
It's www.cctakesteps.org/Santa Clarita.
Perfect. Thank you so much for coming out. And Mom Heidi, you're here with your support. Wanted to at least acknowledge and give you some props on the air. Great. Thanks so much for stopping by, guys. And we wish you the best of luck on this event.
Thank you.